I didn't want to go to bed that night. My parents told me, "Don't worry, you won't miss it. We'll wake you up." They did, and I remember watching him. And I remember splashdown and also going into the quarantine and seeing all that on television. When I was a little kid, I used to play astronaut in the backyard. Neil Armstrong and others like him are what inspired me. They were my heroes. I'm Nils Larson. I'm the lead project test pilot for NASA on the X-59 from NASA Armstrong Flight Research Center. Neil Armstrong flew the X-15. There were a couple other aircraft that he flew, the early dinosaur program, which was somewhat similar to a space shuttle. I sit approximately where his desk was when he was here. All these guys that were our heroes, you know, to kind of see that you're sitting where they used to sit, that's pretty cool. Well, I had the pleasure of meeting Mr. Armstrong a couple of times. Back when I was in the Air Force flying U-2s, he did a program called First Flights, and he came out to fly the U-2. One of my friends was the instructor who got to fly with Mr. Armstrong. The U-2 is a difficult airplane to fly. It's very challenging, especially in the landing phase. One of the things that'll happen with the U-2 is it has a tendency to skip back into the air if you don't flare it out quite enough. Mr. Armstrong, on his first landing, had a very slight skip, maybe 6 inches, you know, something that every one of us would have taken in any day. The instructor keyed the mic and said, "That's one small skip for man," and then said, "Sorry, sir, I had to." So we all thought that was kind of funny. And I remember asking him later, I go, "So what's it feel like to have flown with Christopher Columbus?" You know, he had to pause for a second. He goes, "Wow, that is pretty cool." The really cool part was when everything was done, we had a squadron bar, and he came up to the squadron bar, and we all got a chance to meet him and talk to him. Everybody wanted to know what he thought of our airplane. You hear a lot of different stories about the man, and he really truly was an engineer and a test pilot first. It was really great because we kept asking him, "What'd you think of our airplane?" And he told us, you know, and talked about, you know, what he thought it was like to land and all the different aspects of the airplane. And so, you know, for the first minutes, you know, maybe even half hour that we were there, we didn't talk about the moon or going to space or anything like that. It was about our airplane and what he thought of our airplane, and we were excited to hear his thoughts on our airplane. Eventually we got to talk about the moon, and as time went on, other people would come in, we'd talk about their flight that day, and you know, the pilot community likes a little good-natured ribbing. People, you know, gave each other a little guff back and forth. I remember Mr. Armstrong standing there with a beer in his hand and says, "This is what I really miss, the camaraderie of the squadron." It was like he was a member of our squadron for that day, so that was really pretty cool. Of course, everybody wanted to buy him a beer. Everybody chalked it up on their tab, you know, so we could make sure that we all had the chance to buy him a beer, even though he only drank one. That was the first time I got to meet him, and that was pretty special. That was pretty interesting. One of the other times I got to meet with Mr. Armstrong, it was early in my career here at NASA. We were working on a study for a lunar lander research vehicle or training vehicle. We were down in Houston for a meeting with several of the moonwalkers. We were sitting there at breakfast. Harrison Schmitt was already there, so he was at one end of the table, and I was the last guy through the line, so I was way at the other end of the table. Luckily for me, I wasn't truly the last guy there. The last one was Mr. Armstrong. So he came and sat right next to me. So we all knew who he was. That was kind of obvious. So we went around the table and all introduced ourselves. I was the last one to introduce myself. And at the time I said, "Well, I'm you," about 45 or so years ago. And he just kind of looked at me and I said, "Well, I'm the, you know, Dryden test pilot assigned to the LLRV, LLTV," which, you know, originally before he became an astronaut, he was the guy that was on the study back in the 1960s, and here I was in the 2009, somewhere around in there, guy on that study. So that was pretty cool to, you know, get to meet him and talk to him about that. Watching, you know, the astronauts and going to the moon the first time is what put me on this path to go study and become a test pilot. I think it's really interesting that I get to sit in about the same place that he used to sit, and it's pretty daunting and inspiring and just plain awesome when you think about it, when you're looking out the same window and looking down the taxiway and kind of reflect back on how you got here. Neil would have been 89 this year, so happy birthday, Neil.